So listen, okay, listen, somebody asked me before about something. Now, this is the sort of thing that I might dig around on my gap. If you've got 5 minutes, I'll say, look at this. Now, here, let me get one of the camera. So see what's happening now, as the light is moving across, moving into my diaphragm, I say stop there. Because what I like is the light just hitting her right eye. So dramatically, that's, can you zoom in on, just zoom in on the face a bit, the other zoom in. See that? Now, pan back to the left,
yes, sir.
On the light. Now see the light's going to start going more to the shadow side of her face, more. Now, that could depend, for example, on the actress's nose. She's got sort of an average-sized nose. If she had a smaller one, the light would pass over her nose to the shadow side of her face. So it depends on the shape of the face of the person that you're lighting. Faces are brilliant to light. You can pretty much any lighting principle you can do on a face. Some people say an egg because it's smooth and round. I love faces. Now, start, this is full spot, 2 kilowatt light. Start, leave it there, tilt it up now. And you see how things start to see more light goes at the corner, behind. But say this was a slightly dramatic scene, I would probably go back to where we were, tilt down, and now pan to the right. Pan to the right. Cool. That I like. Now we're getting a bit of spill light in the background there, so it will be easy to flag it off. I won't worry about doing that now. In other words, just to make this a bit darker in here, take some light off here. But I won't. So dramatically, for a dramatic sequence, I like that light. It may be, for example, see the edge of the door? Just hang it about there because it gets some sort of more depth between the darker side of the hair and there. It might be a little bit too light, in which case I'll get a painter. I wouldn't try and take the light off there. I'll get the standby painter just to make it dirty, to paint it dirtier. Okay, let's go to the 5K now. Outside the window, so switch that on. Now, the principles are the same. Now, can we just pan that left? Now, the differences are pretty subtle, but they're there. First of all, it's stronger, you've got a light 2.5 times stronger. And it's maybe if you needed a little bit more light, you know, the 5 kilowatt outside, they say for exposure to use a 5 kilowatt outside the window, because a 5 kilowatt inside would be too strong. Or the alternative, and that's one of the real important thing. There's always another way of achieving the effect. Say for example, there's no, you know, we're up 10 stories, you can't get light outside the window, then I put another 2 kilowatt next to the first one, so we've got 4 kilowatts inside. Okay? Personally, I prefer the 2 kilowatt inside. So can we go back to that, please?
Sure,
so
yes.
Save the 5.
Okay, 5, switch it off, please. Back to the 2. Yes.
Okay, now bring that in. Okay, so there's a dramatic thing. So say now we want it. I'll tell you another thing. See, my eye keeps going to that, this thermos flask thing, whatever it is. So what I'd probably do is maybe put that back in there, move that around there. Or more like that. Then we're focused on the face, the eye doesn't go to the lighter thing that's in the background. The glasses are all okay. Okay, now, don't worry about that. You can leave it against the wall, because I'm going to just show a lighter version of the whole thing. So this sort of lighting would fit closer to the first little thing that we filmed. Remember where it was quite moody lighting? This style of lighting generally is closer to the very first idea. And I'm pleased that the last one did it. No, because this is more me than the previous one. Okay, so now pan that back this way. And tilt up. And now flood it out. Just slowly flood. And if you watch what's happening to the shadow, see what's happening to the nose shadow? There. Now, I find the light source too low. So, if you tilt, what happens? Just keep tilting the light up.
Yeah.
And watch what happens to the shadow here. It starts going down a little bit. But it's not enough. Therefore, see, what's providing the light is a 2 kilowatt light, but the source is this, is the diffuser. That is now the light. That is actually giving us the light in there. So now raise the light about a meter. Watch out for that crap. Watch out above your head. Get rid of that. We can take that away. Now the other thing, which is always interesting, I like doing, where's that flag gone? Something my gaffer does a lot, and I don't know where he got it from, but it works quite well, is, do you want to get the other side of it? It's just moving flags in and out, just to see, and we're doing this on a still scene, which which is, you know, the time we've got is a much practical thing to do. Just keep sliding in, sliding, crossing the line, keep going, keep going, keep going, keep going, more, 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 keep going, keep going, keep going, keep going, keep going, keep going, cross the line all the way. And now come around this side, leave the line where it is, leave the flag, and you come around here. Keep going. More, 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 more. And stop. Okay. Now move it in closer, straight in towards the center, so you make it harder. Okay. Now slide it towards you slowly. Keep going, keep going, keep going. Whoa. Okay. Now put this up on here, put the flag up on that. And then slide it in into the seat. Now keep going. Just there. Oh, stop there. Now take it towards you a bit. No, sorry, it's still towards me.
Left. Left. Whoa.
So that it's not working too much. The point I'm trying to show you is that just keep mucking around with lights and flags and spot and flood and diffusion and so on. And that's how it evolved. Now, dead easy, as I say, on a still shot. The camera's not moving yet because I'm doing it, but it's the principle that I'm talking about. In a dramatic thing, you can take the flag out now. But I sort of quite like that. It's not very nice on him, the light. So what I'd probably do there, maybe a small soft bounce ball, a half a piece of plastic.
Yes, I think so, yes.
Why don't you turn your body towards the light? No, the other way. That's it. And just look at me sort of. Can you see that there? See that on him? Now, see how he's got the light on his right eye? Now go back to where you were, facing me before. No, that way. Just look at me. Now see, he's like, now look at me, straight, that's right. See how he's light and shadow. Now go back, turn your body towards the light, no, other way. Now see, he's got light on his right eye. Can you look at me too, because we see you. So there, just turn your light, so, say these two actors are talking to one another, they're having an argument, so they're not looking at one another. I might ask the actor there just to move his head a tiny bit to your left, just so you see some light in his left eye. It just makes it dramatically a bit more interesting. Or some actors, and this is if you're real lucky, they would use the light. And this is one other thing, just say to an actor, just say, can you feel the light in your right eye? Say yes. Just as you're moving, if it's natural for you, if you don't feel compromised, maybe just occasionally move your head a little bit so we see your other eye. And that's the sort of thing I find, you know, actors can contribute outside of their performance as well. So this is a more dramatic thing. Here, I would probably take the light off the wall. I actually don't like the light through the window, that's wrong. Just maybe, that's full flood, that's full spot, right?
One.
No, the one that bounced.
Full flood, full bounce.
Go full spot.
Go full spot. Full spot, please.
Smells bad.